Then optical fibers. Optical fiber, they don't use wires. They use glass. They use only glass. So this consists of thin, very thin, when you know, very thin strands of glass or glass-like material, which are so constructed so they carry light, light from the source at one end of the fiber to the detector, detector at the another end. So the light sources used, they are either LEDs, light emitting diodes, or laser diodes. They can be light emitting diodes, diodes or laser diode. So the data to be transmitted is first modulated onto a light. So only light passes here. Only light passes using some, we have various frequency modulation technique. So this is modulated on the light, and at the receiver end, the signal is again demodulated. These optical fiber, they offer very high bandwidth, and that makes it capable of multi-channel communication. The optical fiber consists of three layers. As you see in this figure, we have a core glass or a plastic through which light is going to travel. Then we have cladding. Cladding is the covering. This is the covering of the core that reflects the light back to the core. The principle here is, when the light has to be passed on this glass, it has to undergo the total internal reflection, and that total internal reflection is provided by the cladding. Then we have the protective buffer. Protective buffer or protective coating, this is going to protect the fiber cable from any hostile environment. So these are the layers of optical fiber. So the advantage is, it is very immune to electrical and magnetic interference. For any harsh industrial environment, it is very suitable, and it is going to guarantee the secure transmission at very high transmission capacity. This can be used for broadband transmission, where several channels can be handled in parallel. The disadvantage is that very difficult to install, and maintenance is very high because it is quite fragile. You have a glass inside, and it is most expensive of all the cables. If you compare it with coaxial cable or twisted pair cable, it is very expensive. And connecting two fiber, if a fiber is there and if it breaks, there is no point you can connect, because connecting two fibers together or even connecting the light source with the cable is quite difficult. Hence, the connection loss is a common problem. And the light, if it is reaching out of phase to the detector, then the signal will be lost. The fiber optic cable can be of two types. We have single node fiber optic cable and multi-node fiber optic cable. So this single node fiber optic cable, it supports a segment length up to 2 km and a bandwidth up to 100 Mbps. While the multi-node fiber optic cable, the segment goes up to 100 km and the bandwidth up to 2 Gbps.